Well, how beautiful. Thank you, Father. Your grace is my sufficiency in all things. Blessings, everyone. Thanks for joining in. Let us place our consciousness in the space of the beholder, allowing divine love to reveal itself as we listen. Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much, dear Clarion. Yes, it is really coming from an experience that makes all the difference. And I'm glad to be here and join with you in another episode of the Joy series that Master Teacher did about chapter 25, The Justice of God. This chapter 25 of the textbook of A Course in Miracles does offer something that is very much in connection of spontaneous remission, how he calls the word also, of a healing in the mind that really is in that alignment with the healing power of love. And that is also in that first episode and first half hour of the first episode, the title, the theme, the healing power of love that is the light of our mind. And besides the introduction to chapter 25, he will also touch on the beginning of the of lesson 152. Every teacher and student of A Course in Miracles knows it by heart. The power of decision is my own. And yeah, it's how he weaves it into the recognition of quantum science and the immediacy of experiencing healing of the mind, what really the awakening is. Yeah, without further ado, I just give that to you and let's see where it's gonna lead us after that demonstration and allows us for a sharing out of our own recognition and our own experience. So here we go. Thank you.
The Christ in you inhabits not a body, yet he is in you, and thus it must be that you are not within a body. What is within you cannot be outside, and it is certain that you cannot be apart from what is at the very center of your life. What gives you life cannot be housed in death. No more can you. Christ is within a frame of holiness whose only purpose is that he may be made manifest to those who know him not, that he may call to them to come to him and see him where they thought their bodies were. Then will their bodies melt away, that they may frame his holiness in them. No one who carries Christ in him can fail to recognize him everywhere, except in bodies. And as long as they believe they are in bodies, where they think they are, he cannot be. And so they carry him unknowingly and do not make him manifest, and thus they do not recognize him where he is. Look, the Son of Man is not the risen Christ. Yet does the Son of God abide exactly where he is and walks with him within his holiness, as plain to see as is his specialness set forth within his body. Look, the body needs no healing, but the mind that thinks it is a body is sick indeed. And it is here that Christ sets forth the remedy. His purpose folds the body in his light and fills it with the holiness that shines from him. And nothing that the body says or does but makes him manifest. To those who know him not, it carries him in gentleness and love to heal their minds. Such is the mission that your brother has for you, and such it must be that your mission is for him. And such it must be within the framework of the idea of our body identities. It must be for you within the particulars of your determination with me in reflected ideas of the composition of our body form to assume within, we call this justice of God. This is chapter 25 of our Course in Miracles, that on a consistent basis is offering to you the immediacy of an alternative in regard to where you are locating yourself within your own body form. I'm particularly happy that you joined me this morning. We're beginning a brand new series of body identifications that are going to indicate to you the immediacy, should we share this together? This is what we just read, isn't it? Of your capacity as a body, reflected from the purpose of what you think you are, to see in the idea of our organization of conceptual body coming from the power of our mind, standing adjacent to, in another frame of reference of light, is a moment of a complete transformation of your body through illumination that denies the necessity for the conflict of the idea of your particle association that previously constituted your body. We're going to begin this practice with some very fundamental admissions for those of you who have never attempted to be witness to the idea of body formulation, that any practice we would employ in regard to what we thought we were in this correspondence, there must be a fundamental admission that the source of the conflict that we express in our body form is coming from us, not from anything out in the world, and indeed not from anything out in the universe. How simple is salvation? The decision to be who you really are, based on the inevitable evidence that you are choosing and making decisions about yourself. In what you want to be are the correspondences that we are going to attempt in a determination of the simplicity of the idea that I am responsible for what I see, I am choosing the results I want, and everything that is happening to me in my own mind are continuing decisions I am making in regard to what I am. Those of you who are accustomed to the mind training of our Course in Miracles from the Savior of this world, Master Jesus, in his Course in Miracles, are very much aware that you are responsible for what's going on in this universe. Listen a moment. No one can suffer loss unless it be his own decision. No one suffers pain except his choice elects this state for him. No one can grieve nor fear nor think him sick unless these are the outcomes that he wants. And no one dies without his own consent. Nothing occurs but represents your wish, and nothing is omitted that you choose. Here is your world complete in all details. Here is its whole reality for you, and it is only here that salvation is. So we're going to begin with a very fundamental premise based on my certainty as a messenger from out of time, that the representation of me in the message is identical to the messenger. In a simple formulation of how we're going to look at each other within our body forms, it cannot not be that we are offering each other solutions within the arrangement that we find about ourselves in that body form. And if you offer me, I'm looking right at this world now on the new satellite. See, we're broadcasting from a new arc of light, a satellite, down into the conversion of the idea of the mind training of our Course in Miracles, in which we are certain that the power of mind that you represent yourself to be as that body form is infinitesimally small in the idea of the power that actually is inherent in you in a process of self-recognition through continuing conversions of the idea that you occupy a body. So the enigma in the opening of this chapter 25 of the Course says, in no way are you that body. Yet standing with you in complete revelation of what you are is the singularity of all the universe represented by the power of your mind. Okay? The simple truth of the matter, and we've talked about this before, is that the organization of your idea of separation within the speed of light, within the idea of space-time, was actually over a long time ago. This will be particularly evident to you in the mind training that begins with the fundamental admission that you are in a memory formulation of associations of body form, all right, that are continually verified by reflections of light through projection that bring back to you ideas of accumulation of thought patterns in a curriculum of mind identity that in its simplest form is denying you access to the totality of your mind and reproducing images of light form that justify the idea that you're a body. I'm called the Master Teacher, and I'm offering you what has become very commonplace now in the idea of the necessity for the conversion through the action of your mind in self-recognition to momentarily, as we teach, lay down the defenses of yourself with the enemy that appears to be out there, very simply because the enemy out there is you. So that if you see a body form in a projection of the illusion of some other body forms, you cannot not believe that that body form is a part of you in your association with body. So So you set up scenarios within very limited forms of idea of the power of your mind and undergo experiences with an arrangement of the idea of the power of your mind reduced to a pitiful example of your association in body form. How well the old man liked to say of carbon in my body. There's hydrogen, there's oxygen, there's a nitrogen cloud surrounding me. I'm a body in my formulation of association of this limitation. You listening to me? You gonna practice a little bit? You're not a body. Say it. Okay. The you that I'm seeing in the conversion of the energy of your association in a moment of correspondence with each other through the power of our mind to recognize each other will instantly convert the illusion that you are a body form. Here, look with me. The reason that this requires practice within the physicality of your arrangement is you have designed the construct of the illusion of the idea that you're a body into innumerable formulations of justification for particulars of separation that are so innumerable that they're being held together only momentarily by a disassociation from the wholeness of your body, which is in that particular standing next to you, and reduces it to a continuing formulation of yourself, listening, that in effect has nothing whatsoever to do with who you really are. So the practice that will commence from this satellite, from this broadcast to the world, will only be to train you in a continuing systematic way within the memories that constitute the entirety of your body form to show you that at any moment the body cooperation that previously represented your need to retain your separate identities through the release of the defense of the idea of the power, we use the term gravity or dark matter, to resist your idea, to protect yourself in that association, can be instantly converted in the idea we are sharing in a new molecular association of power of mind. One of the terms that Jesus uses was, say to me, transfiguration. There, from the satellite, all around this world, associations, say to me, individual body. Yeah. My concern has to be about your individual body association. Why? The conflict of the body identity is in you, not out there. And as you progress in the idea of containing the limitation that previously held you in bondage, you release it, and while you remain in what appears to be a body form, you can be instantly transformed, let's use the message of the healing practice of Jesus, in a transfiguration of your body, demonstrating the possibility, I think I'll practice a little bit. Want to practice with me what I'm offering you? Say to me, in healing, say to me, spontaneous remission. Did you see that? The miracles that are beginning to occur within our formulation. There was a light factor that just came into here, raised up his hand and said, I'm whole and healed as I was created. And where that tumor had been a part of the figuration of his body, it's no longer there. Can you see that? Because the tumor, as an illusion within his own mind, and this is the guy that was healed. Oh, now this is the guy that has the tumor. Because you retain the idea in your mind of a body formulation that guarantees, oh, he's healed again. Did you see that? Did you see what happened there? Called a miracle. And everybody immediately within the concepts of body form begins to examine you. Let's try it as simply as we can. Are you ready? What happened to your tumor? How are you going to respond to that? You're going to respond to me that you treated it from references of correspondence of your mind that are guaranteeing you a continuation of your body form? Tell me, this is a Course in Miracles. Yeah. It's a Course in Miracles that in effect has absolutely no concern about your body whatsoever. Why would it? You're not a body. Dead? Good. You're free. You're not a body. Is that where the healing occurred? Of course. What did it have to do with the body? In reality, it didn't have anything to do with the body. You're going to be whole and perfect in your mind, no matter how much exercising you do in your efforts to maintain the idea that you are contained within a formulation of the body, completely subtracted from your mind. Can you hear this? The mind of God, which is the source of all reality in all of the universe, have already included you in with any possibility that you could be old and sick and suffered consequences within your own mind that previously justified your idea of body form. Thank you for that. And another practice. I'm a teacher of God. Have you decided to teach this is from Master Jesus? The idea of the possibility of instantaneous conversion in spontaneous remission of a disease that previously caused you concern in regard to your body formulation? Yes. Let's look together. The miracle in no way distinguished the idea of whether you actually had that tumor or didn't. But just as evident to you is where there was a tumor, there isn't one anymore. Stand by. This is the teaching of my Savior Jesus Christ, and now in your revelation. What occurred in the entire conversion of your mind, as we express it, through the Holy Spirit, in reality, had nothing whatsoever to do with your body. But in your need, you better hear this, to protect yourself within your own body formulation, somewhere, if the entirety of the association of healing cannot be identified, it will be denied by you. And in the denial of it, cannot not enter evidences of fear. What can you do with the formulation that's occurring in more and more rapid energy conversions within this continuum of time? Look with me. Begin to make a fundamental admission in the offering of the message we are receiving now that the salvation or conversion of light energy that has held us in the conflict of body formulation at the speed of light in objectivity, in reality, has and will be instantly converted in an instant of self-recognition. For at that moment, practice, your body will be perfect in the illumination of my mind, and everybody had become pretty much aware now that I teach mastership, master teacher, of the certainty of what occurred to me within my own body. And you're just as determined, many of you still are, in the idea that you are going to represent yourself as a body and believe that I am going to represent myself as a body in a formulation of the manner in which we intend to reflect back to each other the continuation of a distance between us in our efforts to organize a form of longevity in how we're going to identify our body in our continuing demonstration of a capacity to isolate ourselves within our own mind and pretend that we're actually that body formulation. Here I am. That's not who you are. The certainty involved in the healing process of the miracle that was performed in that spontaneous remission is nothing but a constancy that available to you at any moment is a complete conversion of the formulation of your light body. And this was the reading for today, and we're going to continue with the idea and perhaps even progress to the idea that you are within a frame of reference of a body formulation, that through an illusion of reflection within universal association is a particle wave identity of energy, both power of energy and power of matter, that in fact is nothing but an illusion within the formulation of the factoring of your containment in space-time. So that the conversion I'm offering you is simply for that moment become defenseless in the idea of the conflict that you feel through the projected association of mind that has contained you within this frame of time, you can hear me now, that actually represents absolutely nothing. I say, it's within an arrangement of a figuration of energy that in its most fundamental sense has no location. It's a matrix of energy of innumerable billions of body identities in which you search for the true you. What we've learned in this first 27 minutes is that the true you of our separate body associations is not out there. Where is it? It's in here. Now, I have gained perhaps a better reflection of light of who appears to be outside of me by a continuing representation of the extension of my mind through light and love of our brother, this of course all from Jesus, to a particular reverence where suddenly we're recognizing each other with our minds, not with our bodies. Remember, God goes with us wherever we go, whether in body form or not, because God is the mind with which we are thinking in this process. Stand by. I'll be back in a moment. We're going to talk about the idea of picturing new frames within the illusion. Let's say it together. God bless us, everyone.
Thank you so much for this demonstration. And I will also put the link here into the chat and in the description. He just continues in the second half like this, and also the second episode is very much worth watching. So let's open our microphones and share what comes into our minds in order to express what his teaching were and is.
Karen, would you like to go first, sister? Go ahead. You're muted, hon.
Oh, so I said hi, by the way. It's been a little while. So, hi, everybody. But one thing for me that Dear One always represented was this idea that he's brought up several times in this video of transfiguration. And he you know, the idea, again, I mean, I've said this in previous times that we've been together, is that he never taught getting old and dying. It seems to be happening, but that is the result of the mind that has projected that idea and is living within the story. And so in this video, the way to release that story finally is the release of all defenses, which really finally may not feel like a very minor task, because we are very heavily defended. We've enjoyed our story. We've created or miscreated whatever this identity for a reason that we hold dear. Otherwise, we would have released it already by now. But transformation finally comes through illumination, as Dear One says in the video. And that illumination comes, it's like the dawn comes after the darkness, because when you finally enter, and didn't he just say in the video that you cannot not enter that place of fear? And in that spot of darkness is when you finally, even if you have not yet let go of your defenses along the way, you let go of defense. And then the light can come. But that is, you know, the dawning is available. But finally, for me, this video was about the willingness to release defenses and to allow the light in that way, and to not hold credence of what appears to be outside of it. We use that as the idea that this world is real, because it seems to assert itself so strongly, because that's what we've made it to do. So finally, it's going to be a willingness to release defenses when it seems like we're afraid and we want to defend ourselves, and to continually do that. And that is where we can go through a transfiguration. It's when the tumor can be dissolved, or whatever seems to be our issue, or what we seem to be, what sickness or what disease we seem to be passing through. Finally, besides by the idea of magic, like medicine healing it, the real healing comes with the release of any idea that we possibly can be sick, and to know who I am in truth. So.
Yeah, thanks. What was coming to me as I was listening was about the frame, and how the frame is the Christ consciousness, and the Christ consciousness is outside and separate from the projection of the body. And the projection that we make, the image, part of our imagination that we project outside, is a reflection. And then we misperceive it and see it as good and evil, which is duality, when ultimately beyond that duality is always this frame, this Christ consciousness available to us. And it was coming to me also the way we always practice the cross, the idea of the horizontal and the vertical access. and how the practice is in the recognition of the equality of the Son of God on the horizontal axis, and then moving into that greater awareness of self-realization of our divinity in the vertical axis, and recognizing the association with the vertical axis collapses time, making the need for the horizontal axis to no longer be necessary. So then he was speaking about the spontaneous remission. And what was coming to me there, I jotted it down, that this is a memory, that this is like a tape recording. And ultimately, we are already, quote, dead or transitioned, because the moment the Son of God made the mistake, it was corrected. So what we're working to do here through the power of decision is our own, is the remembrance of what we are in truth, and holding steadfast to that in our responses to what we seemingly see, so as to move beyond that concept and that projection of duality by just misinterpretation of what we think we are, into a more permanent, consistent experience of living the Christ consciousness. Thanks.
Yeah, thank you so much, Karen and Karen. As he shares right in the at the beginning, this introduction of chapter 25, where Jesus teaches that the body needs no healing and it is the mind that is sick indeed, yeah, which is for me the absolute epitome of all teachings. Like, who is really teaching that, yeah? That the body doesn't need any healing and everything is in the mind. Because if there would be a reality to the body, and therefore a reality to the appearance and the perception of the sickness, it would actually mean that healing would be impossible. And so if this is all directed to the mind, because we all know that mind in truth is all powerful and is God's mind and cannot be less than what God's mind is. So of course I can start working with those thoughts that still believe to be in a body as a body and subject to what the body is occurring. And as you might know of my own personal experience of the last week, the appearance is absolutely there, you know, and the appearance of the reflection, it's all going on in the body, and poor me in the body or as the body, that is of course millions of years old and will reflect and probably will continue to reflect until this all is completely over. But I know and I've recognized through experience that it is in the mind, and that through the mind I can literally see that this is not my reality. And so that's where dear one was going then into that responsibility prayer of chapter 21, I am responsible for what I see, because it is me who is the seer. And so that all these indications also, how he mentioned it about the spontaneous remission, or he used the word instant conversion, transfiguration, is only possible because the reality of the problem is not in the body. In the Eastern philosophy, it is mostly on the highest level taught as the body takes care of itself. Don't worry about it. It takes care of itself because you are with your mind, and the change of your mind changing that appearance of the body automatically. Né? So it doesn't need any attention. And that is, of course, also part of Jesus' teachings in the Course and throughout those 2,000 years, né? Where Master Teacher also comes in and brings more clarification for the human understanding, is even then, hey, and in that context with the instant conversion, and that it is instantly and doesn't really take time, There is also an instantaneous self-recognition involved. I recognize my true self. So everything that seems to be going on as that appearance of sick body and so on and so forth becomes a medium and a help for me for my own self-recognition, for recognizing who I truly am. And then his expression, the resulting expression was that, and the body will be perfect, no? Because then it comes from the extension of whole thought, of mind thinking in a way that literally transfigurates the entire body identity and body appearance. So that's what I got first. Thank you. Thorsten, you want to say something? You can just turn on your microphone.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for this topic today. I never thought that we could find a solution in our mind to be not our bodies, you know, because I'm really afraid about this subject. And now it was with you, Devavan, the last week. It came up, this topic. Now, master teacher is telling us joyfully about a solution. I did not understand the solution, but I will work on it. You know, I can work later on it. Then Karen says it is a willingness that we release our defenses. Yes, this is a starting point, and I feel this willingness right now. You know, I did not have the solution right now, but it is coming. I feel it. And Glorian says it's not the horizontal; it's a vertical. And I also don't really understand what she is telling about, but I can also feel there's also truth in this. Yeah. And you said, Devavan, your story from the last week. I have to really follow up what was happening, you know, in my view and what I got, you know, it's a work for me, but you said it's all in the mind, you know, it's all in the mind. So I got all of this. It's everything there. I just have to figure it out and put it together. It will come. So thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I would like to piggyback a little on what you said, Devavan. And of course, I can only speak from my own experience. And as everyone pretty much knows, I was on the brink of death, minutes away, and totally not expected to live against all odds. And what I maintained in my consciousness at that period was from the teachings, of course, of the Course and of Joel. And it's interesting that we played that song before, Your Grace is My Sufficiency, because that was basically what I kept in my mind's awareness, that this can't possibly be happening to the Christ that I am, the spirit that I am, in a state of grace forever. So I maintained that in my consciousness and my body, forget it. I mean, every complication, everything you could possibly think of. But the recognition to me that all healing is of the mind. So it didn't matter to me what happened with the body. I kind of like set it aside and didn't focus on that at all, just focused on my spiritual truth that I knew was real. And ultimately, where Jesus talks about the happy dream, you're coming into that recognition that nothing has any effect on that I am spirit. So for me, I didn't focus on trying to heal the illusion or, you know, make a better illusion, because ultimately we know that all of those projections, the body, the seeming body is temporary. And we know that it's not going to be maintained because it's an aspect of imagination, the image, the thought. So ultimately, all healing comes of the mind in that recognition through the vertical axis, which is the acceptance of the Christ that I am, the awareness of that, the ever deepening awareness that that is who I am in truth. And then it shuts down the horizontal axis, which is the recognition that we have each day of the equality of the Son of God. So beyond the concept that I see is only the light of God. So that's the practice. but ultimately the acceptance on the vertical axis collapses the need for that practice. So thanks a lot.
Beautiful, thank you.
You know, and that vertical axis ultimately is just total willingness to do God's will, to just be that light. And what I've said before is, as long as you have both the vertical and a horizontal, you have the cross and you have the crucifixion. So what we're trying to do is through forgiveness of every thought, or it really is forgiveness finally is a laying down of every defense too at the same time. Then it all just winds down into a single vertical shaft of light that is the that has everything included within it. One mind, one glorious experience of self, expressed in infinite number of ways as you might want, as God might want, with no more guilt, no more judgment, everything loved. And there's the real joy.
Yeah, thank you. And it is, of course, a choice, no? Do I want to stay on the horizontal and see it horizontally and with all the meanings on there? Because that's timeline. No? And I remember very well coming from a Christian Catholic education, whenever you come together or you bless yourself, you make the cross vertically, horizontally, or orthodox in the other way around. But when I came across Jesus, no, as my brother with the course, it was more like just horizontally the direction towards heaven, given or with both arms up. There was no horizontal symbolism included anymore either. And what I think also I could use that too, because there was one line that the master teacher also mentioned about the message and the messenger. And he made a clear statement that the message and the messenger must be identical. The message is identical with the messenger. That is really where the vertical alignment is. No? As long as the message isn't identical with the messenger, I still have somewhere a horizontal thing that needs to be filled in or completed and so on and so forth. But when there's the clarity, okay, I am literally the manifestation of the message of Christ's resurrection, let's say, or awakening of mind, and then the message and the messenger are vertically aligned. No? Thank you.
I love that, Devavan, because that's really basically saying there's nothing separate and apart from everything. And that's the mistake we made in the beginning, thinking there was. And I like what Karen shared about the shaft of pure light. And that's our reality. And just remembering that. And last night I presented a review of the workbook lessons. And what kept on jumping out at me at the first five lessons was exactly what Karen said. The willingness to let it go. The willingness to let it go is just to be willing to be what I am. So thanks so much, everyone.
Yeah, speaking of I am, you know, everything here is right, is symbolism. Yeah, it's just symbols of symbols, or words are symbols of symbols, and everything here is a symbol. And one symbol that I've, because we're talking about the vertical and the horizontal today, you know, I have for a long time just seen a recognition in words, and what's, if you look, dive into the word sometime, and even the word Jesus, if you look at it, it's like the French je suis, which is the I am. It's without the little I, you know, without the ego, but it's je suis or Jesus. And so the crucifixion of Jesus is just, again, the crucifixion of my holy true self, the I am, you know. So we don't have to be afraid of what's out there. It's just a symbol of something in my mind. And nothing, I've really finally, you, whoever the consciousness is the only one crucified, because everything is within you. And you can see the crucifixion of Jesus that way, the crucifixion of I am. It's what I'm producing while I'm letting myself seem to be within a world that denies me everything except the pure light that I really, truly want.
Thank you, my dear ones. Anybody else would like to add something on, or are we good for today?
Just quickly, Karen, what you just said described the war against yourself. The war against ourself is always warring against the truth of who we are. So that was a great summary of that. Thanks, Karen.
Yeah. Thank you, Maren. Thank you, Christiane, Thorsten. Wonderful that you guys are here also. Thank
nice
you.
Nice to see you all here. Yeah.
Always wonderful to see you.
Yeah. Thank you. Okay.
Thank you.
I'm going to share one more thought and go out with that. Thank you.
Blessings.